Hello, my dear children. Today, I will begin the indirect speech with the discussions on imperative sentences. So, while we have to change the direct into indirect speech, I have already concluded or I have already given the finishing touches, particular to your declarative pattern, interrogative pattern, which is of two types. Number one is the yes-no interrogative. In the indirect speech, such type of yes-no interrogatives commonly begins with E for whether plus subject plus verb. Number three is the WH interrogative is already over. WH interrogative plus subject plus verb. Same type of pattern you have to maintain while changing the direct into indirect speech. Now, I will focus particularly on imperative sentences. That means if the direct speech has imperative patterns or imperative sentence or structure, what type of change that we have to effect while changing the direct into indirect. At first, I will give you a note division or I'll give you some simple thinking or the simple discussion particularly on what we commonly mean by imperative sentence. Remember, your imperative sentence is the sentence that denotes order, that denotes advice, that denotes instruction, also warning, then suggestion, then prayer, etc. So the sentence that denotes or indicates the sense of order, advice, instruction, warning, suggestion, prayer, etc. is called, even request, also request is known as your imperative sentence. In the imperative sentence, your subject you, which is in the second person, you could be singular or you could be also plural. In the imperative pattern, your subject you is generally omitted or it remains understood. That means you can simply believe or you can simply know that certain types of subject, that is you, remains hidden in the imperative pattern. Suppose I order, please give me a glass of water. This imperative sentence understands or reveals the sense of request. If I say, please keep up the grass, it also gives the sense of warning as well as the request. Suppose I order somebody, what? Give me a glass of water. So this particular sentence refers to order. Give me means you give me. Another, study well for your exam. It is the sense of advice. Another example, please think carefully. It is the sense of instruction, or write properly on the answer sheet. It refers to instruction. Use only blue pens on your answer sheet. It refers to the instruction to the examiners or the candidates. Warning, don't dip your finger in the hot water. It is the sense of warning. Another warning, don't run onto the middle of the road. It is the warning, because when we give warning, certain types of danger is ahead. Suggestion, in case of suggestion, our sentence generally begins with let, main verb let. If I say, let's celebrate the victory, it is the sense of suggestion. Let's play football today, it is the sense of suggestion or proposal. Another request particularly begins with kindly or please. And the prayer, have mercy on us, O God. This is the sense of prayer. So our imperative sentence refers to order, advice, instruction, warning, suggestion, request, prayer, etc. Only except suggestion. In the suggestion, our sentence generally begins with the main verb let. Apart from suggestion or except suggestion, all sorts of meanings that are already in the imperative pattern, your subject you remains understood. That means subject you is generally omitted or deleted in the imperative sentence. If I say you come, that means I order you to come. So subject you remains hidden here. If I say study well for your exam, that means you study well for your exam. Similarly, subject you remains hidden or remains understood. So remember, if we find such type of imperative pattern indicating order, advice, instruction, warning, request, suggestion, prayer, wishes, etc., what could be our reported speech or what could be our indirect speech? What type of change that we have to make or what type of change that we have to effect particularly on these types of imperative patterns? With examples, I'm just going to explain you. What type of example? Just 3 to 4 examples I'm just going to give you for your better understanding of changing the direct into indirect speech or reported speech. If I say, father said to me, father said to me, obey your betters. Father said to me, obey your betters. This is the direct speech. Why? Because this is the direct statement or the narration made by father. And father is the reporter here, remember. So if we have the imperative pattern within the inverted commas, that means obey your betters. Remember, what type of sense is there in obey your betters? Remember, sense of advice comes. Because one type of advice that is being served by the reporter father. So if advice is there, simply you have to replace said to with advised, because the sense of advice is there. So in the indirect speech or the reported speech, you just change accordingly. Said to should be replaced by advised. As it should be in the verb form, so she should be changed into s. Father advised, then me is the object. Here me is the object and father is the subject or a reporter. So father advised me. Then your imperative pattern begins with the verb obey. Remember, here obey is the main verb. Obviously, subject you is omitted, subject you stands for me. So obey your betters means the imperative pattern begins with the main verb obey. Remember, if the imperative begins with the main verb, you have to simply add to. That means to obey. This is the to infinite structure or the infinite structure. So father advised me to obey. Then your better means as father said it to me, so your should be changed into my. So father advised me to obey my betters. Then your reported speech comes to an end. And here you get your indirect speech. What type of changes are there? Number one, first you have to understand what type of meaning is there in the imperative pattern. Obviously, your meaning is advice. So as the meaning advice comes, so said to, reporting verb, should be replaced by advised. Said to is replaced by advised. Then obey is the main verb. It should be replaced by to obey, to infinitive. Then your should be changed into my. These three important changes are there while changing the direct into indirect. So one type of example is already over by changing the direct into indirect on the sense of advice. Another example is there. What type of another example on the imperative pattern? If I say, he said to his friend, he said to his friend, comma inverted comma, don't run down others. Don't run down others. Sometimes it becomes very difficult for most of the examinees to understand the sense of the phrasal verb. Remember, what type of phrasal verb is there? Don't run down others. Unless and until you understand the concrete or the real meaning of a run down, it will be impossible for you to change the direct into indirect. So in certain cases, it is mandatory on your part to note down certain phrasal verbs along with their exact meanings in the context. He said to his friend, don't run down others. So what did my run down? Run down means criticize. Don't criticize others. So now obviously you just try to think from the imperative pattern, don't run down others. What type of sense is there? If someone says to somebody else, don't run down others, either it could be advice, or either it could be warning, or either it could be forbid. Remember, here three senses are simultaneously coming from the imperative pattern. So as per the sense, you change the direct into indirect. Now we have to change into indirect speech or reported speech. How can we change? He. Similarly, I have already told you, said to should be replaced by advised. He advised. He advised his friend. He advised his friend or warned his friend. Even you can also say warned his friend. Okay. Then your imperative begins with don't run down. Don't should be changed into also in the negative as not to run down others. Okay, so now your indirect speech is over. Only you have to understand the sense from the imperative sense that is already given in the direct speech. Don't run down other gives the sense of advice or warning. As it gives the sense of advice, so said to be replaced by advised. As it gives the sense of warning, you can also use as warned. But remember, If you want to use the sense of forbid, the pattern should be little bit changed, because forbid itself is a negative word. So in the sense of a forbid, please don't use not to, because a forbid itself is negative. If you use not to with forbid, it will be double negative. Double negative means your grammatical notion or the grammatical pitfall should be there. That means you should, your sentence will be grammatically unacceptable or wrong. So if you want to use forbid, forbid means refuse to do something. So you just write in the sense of a forbid. How? He forbade. The past simple of a forbid is forbade. He forbade his friend. But here, as a forbid itself is a negative verb. As a forbid itself is a negative verb, you don't try to make it another negative. So don't should be changed into simply to. He forbade his friend to run down others. Never use not to run down others. Because in the sense of a forbid, your negative should not be repeated. Don't should be repeated, simply to run down. So I have already told you, in the sense of advice, please revert advised, then not to run down. One, not to down. But if you want to use a forbid in the sense of refusal, you rather use he forbade his friend to run down. Never use not to with forbade, because both express the same negative notion or meaning. Another very interesting thing is about your proposal. Now, just like you give some importance or the attention, particularly on the sense of a proposal. How the sense of a proposal in the imperative sentence needs to be changed in the direct speech. Suppose it is, if I say, the captain said to his players, the captain said to his players, comma, inverted comma, begins. Let's bowl fast. Remember. So this is the imperative pattern. Let's bowl fast. So within this particular imperative sentence refers to suggestion or proposal. As a suggestion or a proposal means, it commonly begins with let's. Let's means L-E-T plus U-S, us. Us is the objective form of a pronoun. It comes from we. We is the first person pronoun plural. So let's bowl fast. Remember, this imperative sentence refers to proposal or suggestion. It is the sense of a proposal or it is the sense of suggestion. I've already told you, if the imperative has a proposal or a suggestion hidden behind it, what should be the indirect speech? In the indirect speech or the reported speech, in the sense of a proposal, you simply replace this reporting verb. How? The captain suggested. The captain suggested, then preposition to. You can use to or you can't use to, because this is purely optional. This is not mandatory. So the captain suggested to his players, okay, that we should be changed into they, that they should bowl fast. They should bowl fast. This is the indirect speech. Remember, if the direct speech begins with the letters in the imperative pattern, you have to simply use suggested, then object, then that, then we should be changed into they, then modal auxiliary should be used. The captain suggested to his players that they should bowl fast. If you want to just make it rather brief or shorten the sentence, you can also change it into indirect in another way. What is the another way? Another way means very shortcut method in the sense of a proposal that begins with the letters. How can it be? Let's see. The captain suggested. The captain suggested to his players or his players, to his players, simply suggested means your next verb will take ing. The captain suggested his players bowling fast. Bowl should be with ing form, bowling fast. If you want to just make the sentence rather crispy, rather brief or shorten, you can also use this indirect speech in another way. The captain suggested his players bowling fast, or the captain suggested to his players that they should bowl fast. So it is in the use of suggestion. So remember, your imperative pattern means what type of sense is there in the imperative sentences. First, you understand the sense. If the sense refers to order, you have to use order by replacing said to. If the sense is there request, you can use requested. Another interesting thing from the request, I'm just telling it. What is the sense of request is there? Suppose if I say the patient said to the doctor, the patient said to the doctor, comma, please give me some painkillers. Painkillers, one type of medicines that kills pain. So the patient said to the doctor, please give me some painkiller. So this is also the imperative pattern. This is the imperative sentence. And as the imperative sentence begins with please, so this imperative sentence refers to the sense of request. So obviously, as the sense of request comes from this imperative sentence, now change accordingly in the indirect speech or the reported speech. Obviously, said should be replaced. So the patient requested. Understand? If you don't want to use requested, you can also use begged. B-E-G-G-E-D, begged. Begged means also requested. The patient requested or begged the doctor. Okay? Then here, give is the main verb. As usual, this main verb should be used with the to give, and me should be changed into him, to give him some painkillers. So the patient requested or begged the doctor to give him some painkillers. Okay, and even you can also use pleaded with the doctor. Begged means pleaded with. Remember, pleaded is the verb that comes, pleaded also comes from the noun plea. So, but whenever you use pleaded in the sense of requested or begged, use the preposition with. So the patient requested or begged or pleaded with the doctor to give him some painkillers. So now I just completed the direct into indirect speech on some important examples of imperative sentences. But always remember, your imperative sentences means first you have to understand the sense in the direct speech, then you have to convert the direct into indirect speech by using either advised or order or requested or suggested or warned, etc. So now I just lucky completed your direct into indirect pattern, particularly on the imperative sentences. I do sincerely hope that you must have enjoyed my class today, particularly on the imperative pattern while changing the direct into indirect speech. My children, you just remember, when I will be taking your next class just after a few days, I will be simply focusing on the imperative sentences on another important pattern of the direct speech, that is called exclamatory pattern or exclamatory sentences. Because exclamatory, I think it is the high voltage sentence, because commonly when your direct speech has exclamatory sentences as exclamatory patterns, lots of rules are there you have to execute or you have to implement while changing the direct into indirect. But for your better understanding, I will make the certain types of rules rather very simple or very easy, so that you can have a complete grip over the patterns of the exclamatory sentences when you have to change the direct into indirect. So in my next class, I will be simply focusing on the use of exclamatory pattern from direct to indirect speech. Exclamatory, you commonly know, the sentence that ends with exclamatory sign, and it produces or gives the sense of exclamation or wonder or surprise, emotion of surprise on the sense of happiness, joy, hatred, praise, admiration, etc. These patterns are called exclamatory sentences or exclamatory pattern, commonly ending with the exclamatory sign. So next class, I will be purely focusing on the pattern of the exclamatory sentences while changing the direct into indirect. With this, I just come to an end with the discussions of imperative sentence. For your better understanding of the direct indirect, you just wait for my next class on the exclamatory pattern of the indirect speech. That's all for today. Just have a good day.